say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight on the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets we roared, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
everybody. So, I'm going to begin my speech with a story about a student who is sitting on the field tonight. And I'm not going to mention her name, but if she starts giggling, you will immediately know who she is. There you go. So, after the end of first semester, this student decided that at least once a week, she was going to have an epiphany where she would tell everybody that she could get to listen, "Guys, we're graduating." And every time she said it, I thought, well, yeah, we're graduating. That's just what happens next. But as I continued to think about graduating, I realized it's not just what happens next, and it certainly doesn't just happen. Graduating is the total result of every community member giving their all to help us make it through. And when I say every community member, I'm not kidding. Everyone, including parents, teachers, friends, the school board, business owners, the checkout people at Safeway, and total strangers are all a part of our community. Graduating is a community effort. It isn't only a celebration of the graduates and everything we've accomplished, or a celebration of the teachers and staff and everything they've done for us. We put on graduation so that everyone, from the families to the scholarship committees to the perfect strangers, can see the glorious result from all the many years of hard work that they've put into this moment. I know everyone is just waiting for the cliche, so I'm just gonna say it. They say it takes a village to raise a child, and obviously it's true. As we celebrate everyone who is here graduating today, I'd like to take a moment to honor our classmates who are unable to celebrate with us. Amy Martinez is a gentle, kind-hearted young woman who has attended school with many of us since the first grade. She has been battling brain cancer for several years now and is unable to be present for our ceremony. She is in all of our hearts tonight as she faces all the challenges life hands her with a smile and an indomitable spirit. Many of the students on the stage today remember Nicholas Fales. Nick passed away in January of 2004 from health complications, which devastated all of us as fourth graders. But we know that Nick's spirit will be with all of us, cheering us on as we cross the stage. This year, our class suffered the heartbreaking loss of another student. We would like to honor Rosario Angel Villa. En honor a Rosario Angel Villa, dejamos ir estos globos en su memoria. We would like to release balloons to remember Rosario. Okay. She overcame many obstacles to earn her diploma and would be proud to celebrate with us today.
Ella superó muchos obstáculos para obtener su diploma y estaría orgullosa de celebrar la graduación hoy con nosotros.
Her parents would like to thank her friends, the principals, the teachers, and our community for their support and their caring hearts.
Sus padres les dan las gracias a sus amigos, los directores, maestros y a la comunidad por su apoyo y su gran corazón.
Tonight is a celebration of the achievements of all the students. This is the final, long-awaited conclusion of all the work we've done to reach this point. It is my honor as a member of the class of 2012 to welcome you to our commencement ceremony. Thank you.
Members of the Board of Trustees, distinguished faculty and staff, members of the class of 2012, and parents and friends, it is my honor to welcome you all to Fort Bragg High School's 2012 graduation. Graduation's a little like Christmas for those of us in education. It just takes 13 years to unwrap the gift. But they were instructed to laugh at the superintendent's jokes or they wouldn't graduate. So far, so good. Anyway, I would like to first off, let me introduce the Board of Trustees. President of the Board of Trustees, Jennifer Owen. Trustee Wendy Boyce. Trustee Michelle Norvell. Vice President of the Board of Trustees, Ryan Perkins. And Trustee Gerald Mattson. They support all of our programs here in the district, and we are all, this is by far the best board I've ever worked for. I just want you to know that. So the word of the day is choice. Finally, after 13 years of not having a lot of choice in their day-to-day life, the graduates are about to embark on a time when their choices will be more important than ever. It's been my experience that the choices you make, even as a young adult, have an immense impact on your life ahead. You can choose to prepare yourself for a career, or you can choose to sit on the couch and wait for the world to come to you. You can choose to build up your resume, or you can choose to build up your video game scores. You can choose to follow your dream, or you can just dream. So how can you tell a good choice from a bad choice? A good choice usually leads to a positive outcome. Good choices can lead to more options and thus more choices. This can lead to feeling better about yourself, not feeling penned into a direction you don't want, and being more confident that your next choice will be a good one. So what happens when you make a bad choice? Well, people make bad choices all the time, but it isn't necessarily the end of the world. You may need to admit to yourself that your choice was bad and then make a new choice. The problem with making a series of bad choices is that sooner or later your choices dry up. You find yourself in a hole that gets increasingly hard to get out of. So I'm pleased to say that all of you back here are starting off on the right foot. You have made the choice to graduate, and that was a good choice. Now I think it's important for all of you to go out and find some more good choices. My sincerest congratulations go out to all of the graduates and all of their parents. Thank you.
Class of 2012. First of all, I would like us all to take a moment to appreciate how lucky we are. We're so lucky to have the opportunity to graduate here today in this beautiful stadium. We're so lucky to have all our teachers, families, and friends here today who have supported us all these years. Think of all the young adults around the world who do not have these opportunities simply because of circumstances they cannot control. Throughout our 13 years of instruction, we were always granted the privilege of having educated teachers, equipped classrooms, and textbooks. Most of us probably took these things for granted, but really, these are gifts that many other students around the globe must go without. We're incredibly lucky. That being said, fellow classmates, it's been a very nice 4 years. We've all grown past the people we were as freshmen and have developed into the people we are today. But rather than reminisce on high school memories and how far our class has come, I'd like to tell a personal story containing a metaphorical message which I hope can be used as advice for the future. So a few weeks ago, I went for a run, which I do practically every day. The route I decided to take began with a very long, steep hill. I was almost to the top of the long, steep hill when my dog began to bark. And I turned the corner, and right there, standing in the middle of the trail, was a big black bear. And I don't know if any of you have seen a bear before, but they're very intimidating. To give you an example, perhaps you know Dylan Cooper, fellow graduate? Pretty intimidating guy, right? Wouldn't want to mess with him. So this bear was about the size of two, maybe two and a half Dylan Coopers. And it was blocking the road. So as you can imagine, I was forced to turn around. But instead of running all the way back down the hill to my car, I ended up taking a side trail, which branches off the trail that I was on. And this trail ended up taking me to the top of the hill anyway, by a different route. So my run was saved. But the moral of the story is, as we all walk our separate roads in life, there's a very strong likelihood that one or two metaphorical bears will be blocking the path. But instead of turning around and quitting, I urge you all to simply find a way around the bear. Take an alternate route and find a way to conquer the difficulty. Life will be all about facing changes and obstacles and dealing with them. We've made it this far already. Fellow graduates, don't give up on your goals and aspirations, no matter how many obstacles lie in your path. Whenever you reach a dead end, try another trail until you find one that works. I wish you all the best of luck. Thank you. FB 2012.
I would like to begin by expressing how truly grateful I am to have this opportunity. I am so unbelievably proud to be able to stand here today representing these extraordinary people behind me, addressing all of you in the stands in front of me and the chairs beside me who have made us into our bright, funny, feisty selves. When I think about this class, I think back to our freshman year when we were herded up into the gym and promised, in all sincerity, that the staff wasn't going to listen to what they'd heard about this class from the other schools. They were going to form their own opinion of us. And there we sat, impish grins already on our faces, eyes already twinkling, not with innocence or excitement, but with mischief. Boy, were they in for a surprise. By the next assembly, the verdict was in. There had never been a worse first week or more referrals from the freshman class. That same class that was the first ever to be banished from the Dana Gray field just a month or two into third grade, and we'd already had one too many crazy games of tag and wild rounds of kickball, obviously, we hadn't changed much. When I think about this class, I think about all the wonderful, experienced teachers over the years who have said, "Your class was so brilliant, really. All of them were some of the smartest students I've ever taught. But my goodness, did they make me want to retire." Give me a sec. And it's true. You really can't have this many smart alecks in one place without a few strokes of genius in there. But when I think about this class, what I really think about is Mrs. Walker at one of our last class meetings. In the library this time, telling us that when we entered high school, she really did think we'd be the death of them. But how proud she was of us, and how much we'd come together this last year. Our class has so many reasons to be cynical about life. Most of us can't remember Fort Bragg before the mill closed down, and we were only in second grade when the Twin Towers fell, and it was so foreign to us, so incomprehensible, that we walked around the playground going, "What's that? Who did it? How could this happen?" And we were still too young to realize that we weren't the only ones without the answers. America has been at war for most of our childhoods. We've grown up watching cities and countries and states destroyed by natural disasters on the news. It was only a year ago that our own sister city, Otsuchi, Japan, was flattened by the tsunami. And by 2008, we were old enough to understand what the economic crash meant for our parents and our town. These will be the great cultural references of our generation. And if we doubt after living through them at such a young age as we have, who can blame us? Throughout all of this, though, or maybe because of it, our class has maintained such a vivacity, such a fierce will to live life by our own terms. There's a strength in that rebellious spirit of ours that's so much a product of growing up in this uncertain time. But if living in this edgy time has made us strong, it's growing up in this place that's given us joy. It didn't really hit me that we were graduating until a few weeks ago, at the end of the senior banquet, when we were handed these little slips of purple paper with just one line on them. Do you remember? We were supposed to write down all our stories from grammar school and high school to be opened and read at our 10-year reunion, 2022. Well, class of 2012, do you remember? Do you remember second grade graduation, when we walked around the Redwood Garden in a long looping circle, red graduation caps perched precariously on our heads? At almost 2 feet tall, we felt so proud, so accomplished, so grown up. Do you remember all those recesses at Dana Gray, the games of bar tag and freeze tag and tag football, and all the grass and wood chips we kicked up in the process? Do you remember the eighth grade promotion dance? And the balloons that the PTA moms had spent hours inflating for us? The little red tables that we sat around, awkwardly avoiding the dance floor? How the girls were still a head and a half taller than the boys? That one didn't last long. Do you remember our freshman year, when the seniors built a whole forest on their homecoming float, and we had one big, droopy hot air balloon? What about this year? Will you remember this year? This homecoming with Toy Story? The logo we took from Buzz Lightyear and put on the back of our class t-shirts? To infinity and beyond. Well, here we are, 2012, day one of infinity. For all that these are snapshots of our class, they're also very much images of our community. Memories that wouldn't have been here without the teachers who made the graduation hats, the yard duties who made sure that, however rough we played, we survived grade school. The parents who spent all those hours decorating for the dance, and everyone who came to judge the homecoming parades. All these people who have taught us and taken care of us over the years. Interwoven into anything we have ever done is this community. Not one of us can say that we got here on our own without the help of someone in these stands or these chairs. I certainly know I couldn't. I'm standing here today because of all the books my mother read to me as a little girl, the hours my father spent at the table talking over dinner. I'm here because of Barbara Stone, who taught me how to write, how to knit, and how to sew. I'm here because of Connie Turrentine, who taught me that everything is a question, and then sent me up to the endless task of finding my own answer with a smile and a cup of tea. I'm here because of all Tess Albin's soccer fundraisers, Lynn Barrett's gruff compliments on the track, and the countless hours Patrick and Amanda Pekin spent poring over notes with the mock trial team. All the lunches Ms. Cochran Keith and Christine Carbone and Linda Roofing gave up to hold Interact meetings. The time Mr. Bell spent advising the newspaper, and the hours Mark Boley donated to mock trial. I am here because of this community. We all are. And we owe you such a debt of gratitude, because you are very much the reason we are who we've become, these strong, quick-witted individuals. Call it what you will, audacity, childishness, spunk, whatever it is, this class has it in scads. We may be trouble, but hey, at least we've got character. And that might just be enough to carry us through. It's what has defined us since we entered kindergarten, chins up, arms already stubbornly crossed, and it will be what drives us as we scatter out into the world. That same stubborn, proud, fast-thinking creativity that made us so difficult in school may be the very thing that leads us to success in life. So at this moment, that's so much about growing up and moving on and becoming, I have one hope for the class that never seemed to take orders from anyone. Don't. Don't grow up. Not all the way. Don't lose those mischievous looks or the questions or the roll of your eyes or the impish smile when you flout the rules and forge your own path. Don't lose that sparkle. Thank you, and congratulations.
It's not a question, but a lie. Good evening, everyone. My name is Bruce Triplett, and I'm the assistant principal here at Fort Bragg High School. It is my pleasure tonight to acknowledge some of the accomplishments that these fine young men and women have done throughout their high school career. The first award tonight is the Golden State Seal Merit Diploma. And each one of these students that receive this will get a special insignia, little seal on their diploma. In order to get this Golden Seal, six or more of their CST tests that they have worked on throughout their high school career must have been in proficient or advanced. And not only that, but there has to be at least four in four separate subjects. So, audience, if you could please hold your applause until I have named all of these students. And students, please remain standing. Cynthia Alvarado Ortiz. Laith Butler. Cassandra Cockwell. Cameron Chambers. Carter Crowell. Lester Drake. Anthony Gay. Kelly Grantham. Amy Harney. Matthew Jones. Holly Kirkman. Paul Owen. Alexandra Shaketti. Angel Soria. Lily Shagrew. And Sam Thompson. And Mallory Frazier. Thank you. The next award is for the outstanding senior in each academic area. And once again, please hold your applause until I have called out all of the names. And please remain standing. In science, Mallory Frazier. In English, Lily Shagrew. Mathematics, Alexandra Shaketti. Social studies, Brandon Pill. Spanish, Anna Leach. Art, Kevin Gonzalez. Ceramics, Casey Rowe. Yearbook, Gracia Sanchez. Photography, Amy Harney. Band, Paul Owen. Choir, Holly Kirkman. Theater Arts, Anna Leach. PE, Laith Butler. Woodshop, Grant Pardini. Auto Shop, Lester Drake. Culinary Arts, Cameron Chambers. AVID, Kiabeth Renteria. And finally, Native Spanish, Lupe Garcia Villegas. Thank you. And finally, this award is for our competitive athletes that not only make it in the classroom, but also on the field. The awards for cross country, Alexandra Shaketti. Volleyball, Jacqueline Jordan. Girls soccer, Amy Harney. Boys soccer, Udiel Ayala and Laith Butler. Football, Tyler Lander. Cheerleading, Alexis Coelho. Girls basketball, Kayla Sanchez. Boys basketball, Laith Butler. Golf, Jaden Soderquist. Baseball, Tony Hernandez. Softball, Cassidy Lowe. Track, Laith Butler. And tennis, Sailor Ware. Thank you, everyone. Congratulations.
Good evening, everybody. With the rising cost of tuitions across the country, this year's scholarships play an even larger role in helping students reach their goals. Thanks to the generosity of our local businesses and organizations, the class of 2012 has earned a combined total of $116,000 in local scholarships. That's awesome. This number does not include the thousands of dollars that students earned in scholarships from the schools they'll be attending and or scholarships offered at the national level. Thank you, Fort Bragg and the surrounding community, for investing money into our future. Class of 2012 scholarship winners, please take note. You'll be receiving a letter in the mail next week from Fort Bragg High School explaining how to claim your scholarship money. So let's honor our scholarship winners. Students, please stand briefly if your name is called. First up, we have the American Legion Auxiliary Sequoia Unit number 96 scholarship. They'll be giving out two scholarships in the amount of $200. And that goes to Dylan Cooper and Anna Leach. The Charlie Bell Service Above Self Award given by Fort Bragg Rotary Club. This scholarship's to be given in Charlie's memory to a student who exemplifies the ideal of service above self, someone who goes above and beyond the expected. It's a scholarship in the amount of $700, and it goes to Kelly Grantham. The California School Employees Association, number 487, Tom Carlson Memorial, for $300, and it's awarded to Burke Whitlock. The Don Campbell Memorial Scholarship, given by Lake Mendocino Engineers Association. It's a $1,000 scholarship, and it's awarded to Carter Crowell. The Coastal Mendocino Association of Realtors, Alan B. Carlson Scholarship for $1,000, and that goes to Anna Leach. The Caldwell Flores Winters Foundation. This is a $1,000 a year for 4 years, and that is awarded to Brandon Pill. The Floyd and Bethina Cooney Memorial for $500 goes to Laith Butler. How about the James G. Cummings Foundation? It's a $4,000 a year scholarship for 2 years, and we have three recipients of this scholarship. And those students are Alexis Coelho, Esther Espino, and Tony Hernandez. The Fort Bragg Community Federal Credit Union, there's two winners for $1,000 each, and that goes to Lester Drake and Brandon Pill. The Fort Bragg District Teachers Association, there's two scholarships for $500 each, and that goes to Laith Butler and Lily Chagrew. The Fort Bragg Fire Ladies, in the amount of $500, is awarded to Dylan Cooper. The Fort Bragg Girls Softball Association Athletic Scholarship. There's three scholarships, two of them in the amount of $250. And those recipients are Cassidy Lowe and Kia Beth Renteria. And a $500 scholarship to Burke Whitlock. The Fort Bragg Grange, number 672. The Fort Bragg Grange has been an agricultural organization devoted to local food, local economy, and supporting our local agriculture in the Fort Bragg community since 1938. There's four recipients for $500 each, and those go to Laith Butler, Anna Leach, Kia Beth Renteria, and Marta Serrano. The Fort Bragg High School Academic Scholarship is awarding two scholarships, one in the amount for $500, and that goes to Jacob Villapando, and $600 to Paul Owen. The Fort Bragg High School Class of 2007 Safe and Sober Committee is awarding $500 to Lauren Tamburini. The Fort Bragg Kiwanis Club is handing out three scholarships, one in the amount of $500, and that goes to Anna Leach. And also two $1,000 scholarships to Kevin Doe and Holly Kirkman. The Fort Bragg Lions Club is awarding two scholarships in the amount of $1,000 each to Lester Drake and Elena Gonzalez. The Gloriana Opera Company is handing out a scholarship for $1,000, and the recipient is Anna Leach. And Anna Leach, why don't you stand back up for the Steve Graham Memorial Peace Scholarship in the amount of $250. The Hawthorne Timber Company scholarship given by Campbell Timber Management in the amount of $2,000 is handed out to Brandon Pill. The Andy and Jackie Johnston Annual Baseball Scholarship is rewarding $500 to Tony Hernandez and Grant Pardini. The Jerry Jewell Fund for the Arts in the amount of $3,000 is going to Anna Leach. Rogan Kimberly Scholarship given by Mel and Susan McKinney is $3,000 and it goes to Lester Drake. The Knights of Columbus is offering $400 to four students, and that goes to Bernardo Hurtado, Kiabeth Renteria, Mauro Serrano, and Lily Chagru. The Lake Mendocino Engineers Association gives the Dan Campbell Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $1,000 to Carter Crowell. Barbara M. Larson awarded for literature, given each year by Peter Larson in memory of his mother, one of the original owners of the restaurant who loved to read. It's $1,000 and it's awarded to Mallory Frazier. The Edith Cooley Memorial, given by Cordelia Champagnier, owner of Fiddles and Cameras in memory of her mother. It's for $750 and is given to Holly Kirkman. Calvin J. McIntosh Courage Scholarship was recently funded with, and it aims to promote equality, self-esteem, and awareness of civil rights issues at the high school level. It's $400 each, and it's awarded to Anna Leach and Kia Beth Renteria. The Mendo Lake Credit Union, in the amount of $1,000, is rewarded to Anna Leach. The Mendocino Caregivers Jack Carter Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $500 goes to Mauro Serrano. And the Mendocino Coast Chamber of Commerce in the amount of $1,000 goes to Amy Harney.
Thank you. I want to remind you that some of these scholarships are given ahead of time and students know about them, and then others you can see the surprise on their face as we read their name. So you know, since we switched, we're a little more than halfway through. So the Mendocino Coast Hospital Auxiliary gave us a lot of money this year. Udi Ayala, $500. Alexis Coelho, $500. Dylan Cooper, $500. Carter Crowell, $500. Kevin Doe, $1,000. Kia Beth Renteria, $1,000. Mauro Serrano, $1,500. Cassandra Cockwell, $2,000. And Kelly Grantham, $2,000. The Mendocino Coast Jazz Society chose to give Anthony Gay $1,000. Mendocino County Youth Project is giving $500 to Luis Avila Cruz. Mendocino Study Club is giving three scholarships this year. Lester Drake, $1,000. Amy Harney, $2,000. And Lily Chagru, $2,000. The National Achievement Scholarship is awarding $2,500 to Mallory Frazier. the Native Daughters of the Golden West Parlor number 210 is giving Sam Thompson $500. Neva Cannon Memorial, given by the Native Daughters, is giving $500 to Maria Perez Puerto. This year, Lester Drake will receive $500 from the North Coast Rotters. The North Coast Builders Exchange is awarding Carter Crowell with $250. The College of the Redwoods Upward Bound Program is awarding $3,000 to Udi Ayala. NOYA Women in Fisheries is giving $500 to two students, Kiabeth Renteria and Maro Serrano. The NOYA Women in Fisheries is also awarding the Yvonne Swithenbank Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $500 to Brandon Pill. So the Vern Piver Memorial, this is a new scholarship this year, and we are pleased to award $1,000 to Grant Pardini. The Portuguese Pentecost Society is awarding Cassandra Cockwell $500. The ROP Culinary Arts Scholarship is giving two awards this year in $250 each to Cameron Chambers and Kayla Sanchez. The Rotary International of Fort Bragg Bill McNeil Vocational Scholarship this year goes to Dylan Cooper for $500. And the Rotary International of Fort Bragg William Shanks Arts Scholarship is for two $500 awards to Anna Leach and Sam Thompson. And the Rotary International of Fort Bragg Dawn Applegate Academic Scholarship, there are several. So this year they award Holly Kirkman $1,250. Lily Chagrou $1,250. And three $2,000 awards to Amy Harney, Paul Owen, and Mauro Serrano. Amy, you sat down too soon. The Sonoma Oaks Japanese American Citizens League Frank Oda Memorial Award goes to Holly Kirkman for $1,500. Seroptimus International of Fort Bragg Scholarship is awarding $2,000 to Amy Harney. And the Sharon Hanlon Edwards Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Marissa Ammerman for $1,500. And the Dawn and Roy Splon Foundation is awarding $750 to three of our students tonight, Amy Harney, Anna Leach, and Mauro Serrano. The Virginia Stoker Memorial Award tonight in $1,000 each goes to Paige Johnston and Sam Thompson. The Ken Tallman Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $500 goes to Cynthia Alvarado. And the Timberwolf Boosters Association is awarding tonight $500 to Holly Kirkman. And two $200 awards from the Veterans of Foreign Wars and Auxiliary of Post 11166. Goes to Dylan Cooper and Anna Leach. The Benny Williamson Memorial Award is for $500 and is given to Burkay Whitlock. The Tom Wirt Memorial Baseball Scholarship has been awarded to Tony Hernandez, $300. And our Gary Wolchek Memorial Scholarship is given by the members of the Fort Bragg Automotive Community in memory of a former automotive repair shop owner and a volunteer to our program here at Fort Bragg High School. And this year, $1,500 goes to Lester Drake. Thank you again to our community.
Ladies, gentlemen, friends, and family, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Fort Bragg Unified School District, we thank you for joining us this evening to celebrate the culmination of many journeys. First, we honor the journey of five women who have served our school district with dedication, commitment, and love. Margie Andreas, Donna Smith, Karen Dunlap, Penny Spencer, and Cindy Russert have all devoted decades of their lives to the children of Fort Bragg. And tonight we celebrate their graduation as well. Margie, Donna, Penny, Karen, I know you're out there. Know that we love you, know that we will miss you. Mrs. Russert, we are here with you tonight as we graduate your final class of students. Please stand. Don't you love the wind? For those of you who don't know me, my name is Rebecca Walker, and I'm the principal of Fort Bragg High School. Tonight we are here for one reason only, and that is for the wonderful students we have right here on stage. For our graduates, their journey began at Redwood Elementary and continued through Dana Gray in middle school. But tonight, their journey through Fort Bragg Unified ends here tonight on this field. For after tonight, the young men and women sitting here before all of us will step off this field and transform from child to adult. I've been perseverating all month on just what I was going to say today because this class holds a very special place in my heart. When we entered as freshmen, I began as the assistant principal. Together, we began that year at Fort Bragg High School a little nervous and a little scared. Probably more scared than nervous. And now as seniors, their teachers and I stand with them enthusiastically anticipating their next phase in life. As I was preparing for this evening, many people found it necessary to give me graduation advice. The best advice I received was, Becky, keep it short. No one's here to listen to you. So, in the spirit of keeping this short, and in the spirit of keeping tonight about the class of 2012, I speak directly to the graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the last time I will have the honor of addressing you. It has been my honor and my privilege to watch you grow up, to watch you cry, to watch you laugh. You have been a group that has given me gray hair and a group that has given me much joy. Thank you for being the group that helped lead Fort Bragg High School to three consecutive years as a silver medal school. And that was achieved and awarded by U.S. News and World Report. Thank you. You're part of that. Thank you for making Fort Bragg High School a better place. Thank you for challenging all of us as educators to be better than we've ever been. I know you laugh, but it's true. Thank you so much for adapting to the changes we've asked you to accept year after year. While it's been difficult, you've done amazingly well. Thank you for remaining strong and resilient over the last 4 years. And thank you for giving so much of yourselves to all of us. We are so fortunate to have had the special privilege of being part of your lives. The security of high school will be gone tomorrow, and you will face many decisions as you begin formal adulthood. Remember what your teachers have taught you, both in and out of the classroom. Remember that we all make mistakes. How you recover from your mistake will truly define you as a person with integrity. Remember that doors open and close for a reason. Listen to the lessons life throws at you and be willing to learn from them. But most importantly, remember that success is not defined by intelligence. Success is defined by one component and one component only, and that is hard work. Work hard, choose work before play, and allow yourselves to experience the pride of ownership of doing a job well done because you should, not because you're getting paid. Finally, I'm going to ask you to remember this town. I'm a transplant to Fort Bragg. I moved here in 1997. And I didn't know what it meant to be a transplant because I didn't understand what it meant to grow up in this community. I could not choose a better place for my children to be born and raised. All of you have been blessed to be here in Fort Bragg. This community truly embodies the word community. Don't forget Fort Bragg. Always remember where you came from, and wherever your feet may take you from this day forward, embody and embrace the sense of community every single person in this stadium has bestowed upon you. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I now present to you the class of 2012.
Good evening. Micah Cardullo. Micah would like to thank his parents and teachers for pushing him through high school. Marvin Parrish II. Marvin will do whatever it is he is meant to do. He thanks God, family, friends, and everyone who cried, sweat, or bled for him the last 18 years. Caitlin Jean Windlinks. Katie plans to work and further her education sometime in the future. She thanks her loved ones who've watched her grow throughout the years. She's made it here knowing she's always supported. Brandon Pill. Brandon will attend College of the Redwoods, then transfer to a university. He thanks his family and friends and teachers for all of the love and support, and his friends for all the great memories. Nicholas Ryken. Nick plans to attend Cabrillo College in Santa Cruz. He would like to thank his family for supporting him through school and Mrs. Knott and his teachers for their support. Dylan Michael Cooper. Dylan plans to go to college and get a degree in physical therapy. He would like to thank his mom, sister, grandpa, and the rest of his amazing family. Kelly Siobhan Grantham. Kelly will attend UC Berkeley, majoring in integrative biology. Many thanks to both her families, her shrinks, her teachers, both her graduating classes, and her gorgeous friends, especially her sister. Laith David Butler. Laith plans on going to Sonoma State University next year and play soccer. He would like to thank his family, friends, and anyone else who has supported him throughout the years. Boomer Andrew Steven Schlafer. Boomer will work in construction, then enter the Coast Guard. He would like to thank his family for putting up with him, his friends for the good times, and Mrs. B for everything. Bernardo Hurtado. Bernardo plans to attend Santa Rosa JC. He thanks his friends and family, even his brother Ben, for always being there. And to the class of 2012, good luck. Tyler Yeomans. Tyler would attend College of the Redwoods working toward a behavioral science degree. He would like to thank his parents for their help and dedication to his success. Matthew Jones. Matthew plans to attend the College of the Redwoods. He'd like to thank his mom and dad for helping him through school and believing in him. Alec Butters Overturf. Alec will attend the Art Institute of San Francisco. He would like to thank his family and friends for always being there. Thank you all. Paul Augustus Labrack. Paul plans to work in Fort Bragg a year and attend Santa Rosa JC and run track. He wants to thank all his family and friends who have supported him his whole life. He loves you all. Jason Joel Flores. Jason will attend Foothill College. Thank you everyone who kept him on track. Family, friends, and teachers, good luck, class of 2012. He will miss everyone.
Cynthia Alvarado. Agradece a sus padres, especialmente a su mamá, por ayudarla en todos momentos. Gracias por el apoyo y amor.
Casey Rowe. Casey plans to travel, work, and potentially attend College of the Redwoods. He would like to thank his friends and family for their support and love. Mia Jean Cornett. Mia will work and continue working with horses. She thanks everyone for helping her get through her high school and her mom for loving her through it all. Jose Antonio Hernandez. Tony plans to attend San Francisco State and major in criminal justice. He would like to thank his parents, family, and all the people who pushed him and supported him throughout his life. Angel Soria. Angel is going to stack paper and eventually go to College of the Redwoods. He thanks his mother and father for doing their best to raise him right and thanks Kayla for inspiration. Yanni Colt Canupas. Yanni plans to attend San Francisco State University and work on a bachelor's degree in industrial arts. He'd like to thank his family, friends, and everyone who supported him. Nicholas Edsel. Nick plans on attending the Academy of Art in San Francisco. He'd like to thank his mom, dad, Maisie, and Cal. He also thanks his friends for all their support. Kayla Nicole Sanchez. Kayla plans on working and going to CR, then transfer to a four-year college. Thanks, Dad, for being her hero, Mom and Rainey for being the best women in her life, and Angel for the happiness. Udiel Ayala. Udi will attend San Jose State University to study kinesiology and pursue college soccer. Special thanks to his family, coaches, friends, and teachers for making this chapter of his life so memorable. Cedar Elise DeMarchis. Cedar plans on either to go to Cabrillo College or play volleyball at St. Mary's in Kansas. She would like to thank her mom for the great advice she gave her through everything and also thank her family and friends. Aaron E. Koski Jr. Aaron plans to work fishing and attend diesel mechanic school. He thanks his mom and dad for everything. To all his teachers and especially his brother, thank you.
Rosa Figueroa Hernandez. Agradece a sus padres por el apoyo y paciencia que la han dado. Also thanks to her sister, friends, and boyfriend.
Wendy Segura. Wendy will attend the nursing program at Mendocino or Santa Rosa Junior College. She would like to thank her parents for all the great support they gave her and her friends for all the great memories. Congratulations, class of 2012.
Guadalupe del Rosario Perez Puerto. Guadalupe will attend College of the Redwoods for a GED and then transfer to a state college. She'd like to thank her parents, Jose, Teddy, Maria, Lacey, and her teachers for supporting her. Jessica Martinez. Jessica plans to work, then attend beauty school in Santa Rosa. Special thanks to her parents, family, friends, and boyfriend. Congrats and good luck, class of 2012, Cynthia Smurr. Christian Perez. Christian will join the Army. He thanks God, his parents, family, and friends, especially his mentors, Mr. Bowie and Ms. CK, who helped him get here today.
Maria Garcia Villegas. Maria quiere agradecerle a su mamá y hermana por apoyarla. To her teachers, thank you, and good luck, class of 2012.
Alexis Marie Quayle. Alexis plans to attend Sacramento State to major in pediatric nursing. She'd like to thank her mom, family, friends, the Drakes, Metlins, Tuppers, the cheer squad, and the faculty. Lester, she will always love you. What?
Nancy Guadalupe Perez Moran. She would like to thank God, her family, teachers, and Sue for their unconditional support and love. She loves you all. Gracias, mami, te amo.
Taylor Rochelle Murphy. Taylor will enter the nursing program at Mendocino College in Ukiah. She thanks her mom, dad, grandma, and grandpa for their love and support, her brother for being there and putting up with her. Thanks Sanchez, Metlin, and Sneed families. Brandon David Sneed. Brandon will work, then attend trade school. He would like to thank his mom, dad, brothers, friends, and family for all your love and support. He loves you all. Lester William Drake. Lester will be attending the Universal Technical Institute. He thanks his mom, dad, sisters, his family, the Johnsons, and Alexis for all of their love and support throughout. Maricruz Eck Gangora. Maricruz will work for the summer. Gracias a mis padres y maestros, Mr. Brown, Ms. Oliphant, and Ms. Fishman for all their support, and my friend Rosario that passed away. Julio Cesar Romo Peñafiel. Julio is planning to work and attend the College of the Redwoods. He is thankful to all his teachers who supported him during his 4 years, but especially to his brother Rene.
David Estrella Villaseñor. Le da gracias a Dios, su familia, amigos y maestros por apoyarlo, especialmente a su mamá por todo su amor. Ay, perdón. Elena Soledad González Díaz. Agradece a sus padres, Francisco y Clara, sus hermanos y hermanas por todo el apoyo. Los ama. Thank you, class of 2012.
Maria Perez Puerto. Maria plans to attend College of the Redwoods. She would like to thank her mom, dad, and her family for always being supportive and pushing her to be successful. Alexandra Marie Schicchetti. Alex plans to attend the University of Idaho to study exercise science. She would like to thank her family, friends, coaches, and Luna. Hayden James Cavello. Hayden will attend Northwestern Lineman College in Orrville. He thanks his parents for putting up with him, his sister for all the good times, and Mariah for always being there for him. Austin Cordell Quinton. Austin will attend Hawaii University in Business Administration. A special thanks to Mr. Erguin for his support, kindness, and making Spanish an easy class. Austin Samuel Bearden. Austin is off to Alabama to start a career. He thanks his grandfather for always believing in him and his grandmother for keeping him strong. Gracia Sanchez. Gracia will be going to Maranello Beauty School. She would like to thank her parents, sisters, and Kelly for all the support. Congratulations, everyone. We made it. Garrett Scott Lancaster. Garrett will join the workforce after graduation. He would like to thank his family and friends. Carolina Garrido. Carolina will work and go to College of the Redwoods and hopes to transfer later. She thanks her family, teachers, and friends for helping her throughout the years. She loves you all.
Esther Espino. Le da gracias a Dios, sus padres, familia y amigos por todo apoyarla y ayudarla en todos momentos.
Jaden Ray Soderquist. Jaden will work for the summer, then enter the Coast Guard. He'd like to thank his parents and everyone who believed in him. Amanda K. Labou. Amanda would like to thank her parents and her family for all their love and support for getting her here. Sailor Ware. Sailor will attend a junior college and major in psychology. He'd like to thank his closest friends for their unwavering support and caffeine for all the long nights. Angel Uluak. Angel will work and go to college. He would like to thank his family, friends, and teachers for supporting him and helping him. Grant Austin Pardini. Grant will attend Northwest Lineman College. Thanks, Dad, Mom, Jake, and the whole family for supporting him throughout the years. Thanks, friends, and congrats to 2012. Lily Collins Shagru. Lily will be attending Harvard University and majoring in government. She would like to thank her family, Barbara Stone, Connie Turrentine, and Tess Albin for their constant love, support, and encouragement, and to Alex for sharing the ride.
Anthony James Gay. Anthony will attend Skyline Community College, then transfer to a four-year university. He thanks his mom and dad for every bit of love they have given him. He thanks his friends. He loves you. Tanya Annette Beatty. Tanya will work at CV Star, and in her free time, she will write and draw. She thanks her friends and family for supporting her through all of this. She loves you all.
Liliana Bermudez. Liliana plans to work and attend College of the Redwoods and study psychology. She thanks everyone who helped her get to this point in her life, especialmente a su familia por todo su apoyo.
Kevin Doe. Kevin will attend UC Santa Barbara and major in biology. He would like to thank his friends, family, teachers, counselors, but most of all, his mom for always being there. Burke Whitlock. Burke will attend UC Santa Cruz. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for their love and support they have given her to get where she is, especially her mama. Mauro Garcia Serrano. Mauro will attend Loomis Chafee in Windsor, Connecticut as a postgraduate student and play soccer and run track. He'd like to thank his mom and dad, his mentors Lisa and Sylvia, and the community for making this possible. Cassandra Jean Marie Hamito Cockwell. Cassandra will attend UC Davis in their neurobiology, physiology, and behavior programs. She gives immense thanks to her mother, father, sisters, Grandpa Daryl, her second family members, loving friends, and her animals. Anna Christine Leach. Anna plans to attend Sonoma State, pursuing a dual major in theater and history. She wishes to thank her friends, teachers, counselors, Jenny, grandma, and most importantly, her mom, a real-life superhero. Carter Reed Crowell. Carter plans on attending the University of the Pacific, where he will be studying biomedical engineering. He would like to thank his family for always pushing him, his friends for helping him, and this great school for teaching him. Chelsea Mae Green. Chelsea plans to take a year off and travel. Chelsea would like to thank all of her friends, family, and teachers for their love and support throughout the years. Amy Harney. Amy plans to attend College of the Redwoods and begin her travels around the world. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers. She appreciates everyone who has supported her throughout the years.
Kiabeth Itzel Renteria. Kiabeth will be attending CSU Sacramento to major in nursing. Quiere agradecerle a sus papás por todo su apoyo y cariño. She also wants to thank her little sister, her little brothers, Madeline, Mark, Ms. B, and Mrs. Farrell.
Kevin Smith. Kevin plans to get a job and go to school. He would like to thank his family, God, and friends. A special thanks to Jerry, Lisa, and Sue for helping him on his way. Paul Thompson Owen. Paul will attend UC Davis and study economics. He thanks his teachers, friends, brothers, mom and dad for everything they've done for him over the years. Paige Johnston. Paige will attend Butte Junior College. She thanks her mom, dad, brother, and her grandpa Andy. Cameron Chambers. Cameron will attend the Art Institute in San Francisco. He'd like to thank both his mom and dad for being there when he needed them, his friends for helping him through the rough times. Cassidy Faye Lowe. Cassidy will attend Santa Rosa and play softball. She thanks mom, dad, Cody, Lindsay, and her grandparents for all their love and support. To her friends, you guys are the best. Marissa Ammerman. Marissa will attend Santa Barbara City College in international business. She would like to thank her parents, friends, and Herman for their support and love. Lauren Paige Tamburini. Lauren plans to attend Little's Redwood Empire Beauty School College to become an esthetician. Thank you, mom and dad, for the unconditional love. You are my heroes. To my grandparents, thank you for the happiness, and Renee for the memories. Mallory Frazier. Mallory will attend Stanford University in the fall and major in biomechanical engineering and a minor in women's studies. She wishes to thank her friends, family, especially Naomi, and all her teachers, the Fort Bragg Public Library, and her goat. Yeah. Selena Van Pierre. Selena plans to keep working, then study dance and cosmetology. She would like to thank her mom and dad for all they have done. Also, Ms. Stever for helping her through her senior year. Holly Kowase Kirkman. Holly will be attending Emerson College, majoring in print journalism. She thanks her supportive family, tolerant friends, and her drivers when she was stranded. To her teachers, coaches, mentors, and den mothers, she will make your efforts worthwhile.
Luis Angel Avila Cruz. Luis plans to go to Mendocino College and work full-time. Agradece a sus padres por todo su apoyo. He thanks teachers, friends, and Carla for everything. Class, we made it.
Trent Vichy. Trent's next step is to begin a technical education in diesel, dirt bikes, auto, and fabrication. He would like to thank his family and many of the staff here for their support, these past years especially, Mr. Skinner, Mrs. Walker, and Mr. Urbani. Jacqueline Kuklum Jordan. Jacqueline is going to escape reality to the Never Never Land. She would like to give special thanks to all of her friends for always being there, Mom, Dad, Brandy, and Dustin for being the best family. Tyler Michael Lander. Tyler plans to go to Santa Rosa JC and play football. He thanks his family and friends for the fun times and support through the years. He loves you all. Sam Thompson. Sam will attend San Francisco State in cinema. He thanks his parents, friends, and the partner scholarship program. Deidre Lenora Vaughn. Deidre will attend College of the Redwoods and transfer to a four-year college to major in theater arts. She would like to thank her family, friends, coaches, and teachers. Good luck to the class of 2012.
Stella Peterson. Stella will help Mrs. Payete at summer school. She will start TLC in the fall and get a job. Thank you, Mom, Dad, and Mrs. Payete for helping her get through high school. Kyle Beckman. Kyle is going to have fun after he graduates. Thank you, Mom and Dad. He is going to miss everybody.
I love you too.
Cristian Fermoso. Cristian hopes to attend the National Polytechnic Institute. He would like to give special thanks to his many teachers. Adam Florentino Valenzuela Yanez. Adam plans to attend Santa Rosa Junior College and take business classes. He would like to thank his mom, dad, and family for always being there and pushing him through high school and graduation. Kevin Gonzalez. Kevin will work in roofing and study plumbing. He would like to thank his parents for helping him and Mrs. Finkelstein for her patience and support. William Eric Hamm.
William will start working for his dad. He thanks his family for their love and all of his teachers, especially Ms. Sue Seaver, for all her support and help. Roberto Miranda. Roberto will attend Santa Rosa Junior College. He would like to thank his mom, friends, family, and Fort Bragg High School faculty for all the love and support. Jacob Villalpando. Jacob plans to attend Westminster College. He would like to thank his friends and family for making his life easy, wonderful, and loving. Gage Michael Morgan. Gage hopes to attend Mendocino College and play football. He thanks his mom, stepdad, dad, grandparents, Amanda, and Ms. Sue Stever for all their help and support. Peter Alexander Norman Claire Dorn Ravlin. Peter will work and attend College of the Redwoods until he is able to transfer to the Art of Film School in San Francisco. He would like to thank his teachers for their hard work. He wishes his mother, father, and brother were here to see him. He also thanks his new family, Cynthia and Marshall, for all their love and support. Lorelei Soto. Lorelei plans to go to Santa Rosa JC to study athletic training. She would like to thank her mom, Faraday, Anthony, Jason, and all her friends and family who have helped her make this year successful. Carl Jones. CJ will attend College of the Redwoods and study behavioral science. He would like to thank his family for all their love and support, and would like to thank his friends as well for all their support.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Dr. Armstrong, Superintendent of Fort Bragg Unified, and the Governing Board of Trustees, I present to you the graduated class of 2012. Graduates, you may move your tassels.